Good evening, everyone. This is session 2 on cancer biology. So I welcome everybody. Very good evening to everyone. So this is the session on cancer biology. So yesterday we finished one session on cancer biology. So this is the second session on cancer biology. So I hope everybody is here online. सो शुरू करने से पहले मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगा दैट यू नीड टू गो टू द गूगल प्ले स्टोर. गूगल प्ले स्टोर पर जाने के बाद यू नीड टू इंस्टॉल द अनअकैडमीज लर्निंग ऐप एंड देन यू नीड टू सेलेक्ट योर गोल. सो इन द सेलेक्ट योर गोल कैटेगरी यू नीड टू सेलेक्ट CSIR यूजीसी नेट. सो एक बार सेलेक्ट करने पर CSIR यूजीसी नेट यू विल गेट एक्सेस टू ऑल द फ्री कोर्सेज फ्रॉम टॉप एजुकेटर्स दैट इज अवेलेबल फॉर फ्री. सो यू कैन गो एंड अटेंड दोज लेक्चर्स. Then for the CSIR UGC NET subscription, if you want to go for more, then you need to go for the plus subscription. So that plus subscription is available for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months and 24 months. Well, I would recommend that each one of you go for 12 months to 24 months of subscription, because this is an exact amount of time that is needed for clearing any exam. So in my opinion, you should go for 12 months to 24 months of subscription. Then there is the CSIR UGC NET subscription is there. So you need to finish your course in stipulated time interval. So whatever the time is there, so you need to finish your course. And I think 12 months is a good amount of time to finish the course well in time and also appear for the examination twice. Then you have to use my referral code. My referral code is HY10. So you have to use my referral code and you need to continue for the payments. So this is the referral code. The referral code is HY10, which you need to apply, and then you need to proceed to the payment. So payment can be done either by debit card or by credit card or by EMI, and these EMI are all no cost EMI. You can also do the payment by net banking. So guys, you should hurry up because the prices are already hiked. And now the prices will be revised, so the prices are getting increased. So you can get your subscription as soon as possible. So this is about me. Myself, Manju Yadav, and I teach in CSIR UGC NET category. So I've cleared CSIR UGC NET JRF several times. I've also cleared ARS NET in Agriculture Biotechnology, and I've also cleared GATE BTB top ranks. So something about me. So I've studied M.Tech at IIT Kharagpur. In biotechnology and biochemical engineering, I have cleared CSIR NET JRF areas NET in agriculture biotechnology. So this is about me. So you guys can follow me on Unacademy. So this is about me, and you can watch my special classes that are there. Bernali Sina, hello, good evening to everyone. Hello everyone, good evening. So you can visit the Unacademy's website and or the Unacademy learning app, and there you can search my name and you can follow me. So you are at the right platform, because this is India's largest learning platform where you can crack CSIR. So in case of Unacademy subscription, when you will be getting the plus subscription, so it has several advantages. So you will be getting live classes, you will be getting test series and quizzes, and you will be getting doubt clearing sessions. So these are all the important things, and then you get the opportunity to learn with the top educators. So you will be getting opportunity to learn with the top educators. So this will be another advantage. Iske saath hi saath aapko milti hai daily live classes, you will be getting live tests, you will be getting unlimited access. You'll be getting unlimited access. So one subscription gets you access to all our live classes and recorded courses to watch from the comfort of any of your devices. So this is my referral code. You can use my referral code. My referral code is HY10. So you can use my referral code for getting the subscription, and I would like to announce that batches are starting from 1st January 2021. So that is from the new year time. So these are the complete courses for CSIR June 2021. So you need to stay tuned for more updates. And then there is a batch one that is getting started in case of life sciences, and that batch is starting from 8th January 2021. So you can take that batches. So Barnali Sinha का एक क्वेश्चन आया सर, कैन प्लीज टेल मी अबाउट द एट्रैक्ट सिलेबस. सो कैन यू बी लिटिल मोर स्पेसिफिक कि आपको एट्रैक्ट के सिलेबस में क्या जानना है, व्हाट यू नो, व्हाट यू वांट टू नो अबाउट एट्रैक्ट सिलेबस. So if you have any doubt, if you have any particular kind of question that you want to ask, that you can ask. एग्ज़ाम में क्या रिलेटेड क्वेश्चंस आते हैं? सर एग्ज़ाम 9 जन को है, प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस एंड प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस एंड सिलेबस मेंशन नहीं किया है. सो यू नीड टू फॉलो द CSIR सिलेबस. अगर सिलेबस मेंशन नहीं किया है तो यू नीड टू फॉलो द CSIR सिलेबस. सो आई विल टेक द क्वेश्चंस आफ्टर सम टाइम अगेन. सो आप तब तक के लिए CSIR सिलेबस को रेफ़र कर सकते हैं. सो कमिंग बैक, सो व्हाट आर द रिस्क फैक्टर्स? So what are the risk factors that are there? So risk factors, they include the viruses. So there is hepatitis B and C virus, then there is Epstein-Barr virus, then there is Kaposi sarcoma herpes virus, then there is human papilloma virus, then there is human T-cell leukemia lymphoma virus, and then in case of bacteria, there is Helicobacter pylori. So there are chronic infections and their associated inflammation, which are associated with peptic ulcer diseases. There is stomach carcinoma, there is mucosa associated lymphoid tissues lymphoma. और जनरली रिस्क फैक्टर क्या होते हैं? रिस्क फैक्टर्स आर मल्टीपोटेंट कार्सिनोजेनिक मिक्सचर. सो दैट इज लिंक टू कैंसर्स ऑफ द लंग, लोअर यूरिनरी ट्रैक्ट एंड ऑल्सो एल्कोहल कंजम्पशन. सो बेसिकली इट इंक्रीज द रिस्क फॉर ओवल कैविटी, फेरनेक्स, हाइपोफेरनेक्स, लेरिंग्स, ईसोफेगस एंड लिवर कैंसर्स. सो सिगरेट अल्कोहल कॉम्बिनेशन इंक्रीजेज अ पर्सन रिस्क. ऑल्सो आयनाइजेशन रेडिएशंस आर ऑल्सो ऑल्सो आयनाइजिंग रेडिएशंस आर ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट रिस्क फैक्टर्स. सो देर आर एमिशंस फ्रॉम द एक्स रेज. सो एमिशंस फ्रॉम द एक्स रेज, रेडियो आइसोटोप्स. सो एक्सपोजर कॉजेज सेल डेथ, जीन म्यूटेशंस एंड क्रोमोजोम एबरेशंस. सो देर इज पुअर जीन रिपेयर. Then there are some changes in the gap junction intercellular communication. Then there is ultraviolet radiation, which causes basal cell carcinoma, which is a squamous cell carcinoma and melanoma. So principal source is sunlight. So UVA, ultraviolet A and ultraviolet B is there. So it promotes skin inflammation and releases the free radicals. Then one more question has come. Zubair Ahmed is coming. Good evening, sir. May you recommend any good book for cell biology? So cell biology, you can refer. There are so many books. You can refer Gerald Karp. Then there is a book by Alberts. You can refer that book also. And if not these two, then you can refer. There is a book by Cooper. So you can refer cell biology. There is a book known as Molecular Biology of the Gene by Cooper. So you can refer those books. सो कूपर की बुक में भी आपको काफ़ी टॉपिक्स मिल जाएंगे. सो दिट इज़ ऑल्सो अ गुड बुक. वेयर एज देर आर अदर बुक्स सच एज देर इज अ बुक बाय जेराल्ड कार्प एंड देन देर आर अदर बुक्स एज वेल. सो यू कैन रेफर दोज बुक्स ज़ुबैर अहमद. सो वॉट आर द इन्वायरमेंटल रिस्क फैक्टर्स? सो देर इज सेक्चुअल रिप्रोडक्टिव बिहेवियर इन विच देर इज अ कार्सिनोजेनिक टाइप ऑफ ह्यूमन पैपिलोमा वायरस which includes there is a high risk of human papilloma virus. Then there are occupational hazard where there are substantial number of occupational carcinogenic agents which include asbestosis, dyes, rubbers, paint, explosive and radon. So etc. There are occupational hazard. And then it also begins depends on the diet. So there are xenobiotics which include toxic mutagenic and carcinogenic chemicals in food. And basically these are activated by phase 1 activation enzymes. So there are defense mechanisms which get break up, and then there are phase 2 detoxification enzymes. For example, the compounds that are produced in cooking of fat, meat and proteins. Then there are alkaloids or molds by products also. So obesity is also one of the factors. So it correlates with the body mass index. So active adipose tissue is an active endocrine and metabolic tissue. So in response to endocrine and metabolic signaling, adipose tissue releases free fatty acids. So increased free fatty acids give rise to insulin resistance and causes chronic hyperinsulinemia. So it correlates with colon, breast and pancreatic and endometrial cancers. So cancer is basically a 3D disease. So basically there are different cell types, there are different growth characteristics, and it has different molecular profiles. So cancer is a heterogeneous group of diseases and syndromes. Then there are prognostic factors which include grade 1, there is stage 2, then there is tumor type, then there is biomarker which is slide based, and then there are molecular techniques. Then there is prediction of outcome in which there are certain criteria that are different for each cancer type. So there is grade, stage, histology and routine criteria. Then there are patient characteristics that are important. And then treatment considerations are also critical. So when cancer is known as in cancer state, so alternate term is tumor grade. So it is based on microscopic features such as cytology and histology. So cancer state, it reflects the degree of spread for an individual cancer patient. So basically it is assigned at the time of diagnosis and it may be updated as patient progresses. So what are the tumor cell markers? So basically these are the biological markers. Basically these are the substances that are produced by cancer cell or that are found on the plasma cell membrane, in the blood or in the cerebrospinal fluid or urine. So these include hormones, enzymes, genes, antigens and antibodies. So tumor cell markers are used to screen and identify individual at high risk for cancer. They used to diagnose specific types of tumor and they observe clinical course of cancer. Then there are growth factors. So there are some ligands which bind enzyme linked receptors. So signals are diverse cellular responses including proliferation, differentiation and growth survival angiogenesis. So it can signal to multiple cell types or be specific. So these are the growth factors जो कि मैंने बताया था and this is the principal source and this is the primary activity. So one is the PDGF growth factor which promotes the proliferation of connective tissue, glial cell and smooth muscle cells. Then there is EGF which promotes the proliferation of mesenchymal, glial and epithelial cell. Then similarly there is FGF, there is NGF and there is erythropoietin. So all these are the TGF beta, IGF-1, IGF-2. So all these are the growth factors and these are associated primary activity. So mostly there are tyrosine kinase or serine threonine kinase. These are type of receptor complex for this growth factor. So as you can see the ligand molecule is coming and this is the extracellular domain which is in the exterior side and there is a helix transmembrane and this is the cytosolic side which includes the kinase cytolytic side. So when the ligand bind there is trans autophosphorylation. So trans autophosphorylation takes place. So how secondary tumor formation takes place? This is also known as metastasis. So there is primary tumor formation. After that there is localized invasion. Then there is intravasation. So in which there is interaction with the platelets, lymphocytes and other blood components. Then there is transport throughout the circulation. And it may result in the arrest in the microvessels of various organs. So this is how extravasation takes place. So there is formation of micrometastasis and then there is colonization which is formation by macrometastasis. So invasion of metastasis के क्या characteristics हैं? So characteristics are unique to malignant neoplasm. Then there are major causes of morbidity and mortality. उसके बाद there is invasion जहाँ पे it is associated with activated mortality and local tissue independence in vitro. Then there is balance between tissue destruction and synthesis. Then there is cell surface and extracellular matrix that play an important role. So mechanism of spread कैसा होता है? So mechanism of spread is by hematogenesis. It is hematogenous, it is lymphatics, and it required the acquisition of additional tumor characteristics beyond those necessary for invasion. Then there is multiple lesion and then there is organ specificity. So prostate cancer is one which gets transported to either brain, lung, liver and bone marrow. So then there is colon cancer, breast cancer and prostate cancer which can call other form of cancer also. So once in circulation, jo circulating tumor cells hoti hain, so once in circulation the cell must survive the harsh environment, the shear forces, the lack of suppression and the immune cell. So basically they attach and then they extravasate. So what are the possible application for CTC? So current trials in the Europe examine the direct role of CTC in patient treatment. So CTC have large number of application for investigating the biology of metastatic cancer. So CTC have large number of application in drug development where they can be used to identify predictive biomarkers, identify the mechanism of resistance and identify the mechanism of acquired resistance and facilitate pharmacodynamic studies. So this is the cancer stem cell hypothesis. So this is the stochastic model, and then this is the cancer stem cell model. So in case of the stochastic model, there is tumor growth, and in case of the cancer stem cell model, there is no tumor. So these are the key features of cancer stem cell hypothesis. So cancer stem cell represent the small population of total cell, and cancer stem cells have the capacity for infinite self renewal, while non-cancer stem cell have limited replicative capacity. So cancer stem cell can undergo asymmetric division, providing one differentiated cell and one cancer stem cell. So cancer stem cell must balance self renewal and differentiation to maintain homeostasis. So cancer stem cell have generally low rates of cell division. So what are the goals of cancer control? The goals of cancer control is to prevent future cancer, to diagnose cancer early, to provide curative therapy, to ensure the freedom from suffering, and to reach all members of the population. So chemotherapy is effective as it provides maximum cell kill within the range of toxicity tolerated by host for each drug, and it offers a broad range of coverage for resistant cell lines in heterogeneous tumor population. It prevents or slows the development of new drug resistant cell lines. So there is response and there is toxicity. So treatment ke liye we use the anti-cancer drugs. So anti-cancer drugs are the ones which are acting on the DNA and which are acting on the mitotic spindle and which are acting on the steroid hormone receptor. So this is how the drugs are made. So basically what happens on when they act on the DNA, so they damage the DNA. So damage is either by alkylation or by free radical formation. They also inhibit the functions of key metabolites, such as anti-metabolites are produced. Then there are topoisomerase inhibitors. So then there are some drugs which acts on the steroid hormone receptors. So they are agonists and antagonists as well. So this is the name for certain drugs which have been made. So this is the Herceptin. First drug name is Herceptin. So its name is trastuzumab. So it targets HER2 neo, which is a growth factor receptor. Then there is Gleevec, which is imatinib, which targets tyrosine kinase enzyme. Then there is Tarceva. Then there is lapatinib. Then there is Avastin. So basically these target circulating the VEGF ligand. So the principal goal of radiotherapy is to deliver the tumorally sedal dose of radiation to the cancer with the sparing of the surrounding normal tissue. So jo field hoti hai of radiotherapy ki, it involves the use of ionizing radiation to treat the cancer through several mechanisms of inducing cell death. So radiotherapy, it can be used radically with curative intent. सो वाई द करंट थेरेपीज फेल. सो बेसिकली ट्यूमर सेल्स आर जेनेटिकली अनस्टेबल. ट्यूमर्स कैन बिकम ड्रग रेजिस्टेंस. ट्यूमर कैन रिमेन डॉर्मेंट फॉर ईयर्स. ट्यूमर मेटास्टेसिस आर हार्ड टू फाइंड एंड डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सेस. सो करंट थेरेपीज आर टॉक्सिक टू द पेशेंट. So what is there in the morbidity and mortality? So there is metastasis, then there is rupture into major vessels, then there is starvation, then there is infection, and then there is compression of vital organs, and there is organ failure. So how we will do undertake the prevention? So basically physical activity reduces cancer risk. So it decreases insulin and insulin like growth factors. It decreases the obesity, and it decreases inflammatory mediators and free radicals. So there is increased gut motility. Basically there is a healthy diet that reduces cancer risk, and a good night's sleep boosts the immune system. So self-examination is the cause for early detection, and annual doctor visits are for early detection. And education is required, which is its achievement requires knowledge of diseases, process and understanding of social and economic factors. So thank you guys, this is all for today's session. If you have any doubts, if you have any queries, then probably you can ask. ज़ुबैर अहमद सोफ़ी, आपको आंसर मिल गया है, आपको मैंने बता दिया है. एनी वन गुड बुक फॉर सेलुलर बायोलॉजी यू कैन रेफर कूपर और जेराल्ड कार्प और एनी अदर बुक. So if you have any doubt, if you have any queries, then probably you can ask. Guys, the new year is coming and it is bringing new challenges in life. So it is important for you all to remain focused to your goals or enjoy the coming 2 days. You enjoy all and you make a new year resolution. That you will achieve your dream of clearing the exam or whatever is your goal. आप अपने अपने goals बनाइए और उसको achieve करने की कोशिश करिए, because the year 2020 was a very very difficult year for many of us. Many of us they lost their jobs and many of their of them they lost their lives as well. So 2020 was a very difficult year. सो 2021 नई उम्मीदें और नया जोश लेकर आ रहा है. अब तो वैक्सीन भी आने वाली है. सो वैक्सीन इज़ जस्ट अराउंड द कॉर्नर. सो कोरोना वायरस इज अब बहुत ज़्यादा खतरा नहीं रह गया, ऑल दो द न्यू स्ट्रेन हैज़ बिन डिस्कवर्ड. सो यू नीड टू बी वेरी वेरी मच फिजिकली एक्टिव एंड अवॉइड क्राउडेड स्पेसेस. ऑलवेज वियर मास्क एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स, बिकॉज दिस इज़ नेसेसरी टू कीप योर सेल्फ सेफ. And enjoy the new year with this message. I would like to thank you for all your support. And if there are any questions that are remaining, then probably you can ask. Now the CSIR result has also come. So CSIR has declared its CSIR result in the NTA NET category. So now the thing is that CSIR has declared the result. And it becomes more so important. या तो आपका हुआ होगा या तो आपका नहीं हुआ होगा. अगर आपका हुआ है तो it is very good. Congratulations. Start preparing for the interview for different places where you will be going for PhD admissions. एंड अगर आपका नहीं हुआ है तो इट गिव्स यू एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू लुक बैक वेयर यू फॉल वेयर यू फेल शॉर्ट एंड उसको करेक्ट करके इट गिव्स यू एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मूव अहेड एंड टू प्रोग्राम योर सेल्फ इन अ बेटर मैनर सो दैट जून 2021 वाला एग्ज़ाम आप सक्सेसफुली क्लियर कर पाएँ. तो जून 2021 वाला एग्ज़ाम आने वाला है सो आपको कहीं जाने की ज़रूरत नहीं है बिकॉज ये एग्ज़ाम बहुत ही नज़दीक है. सो इस एग्ज़ाम के लिए आप प्रिपेयर करना स्टार्ट कर दीजिए एंड आई होप यू विल क्लियर दिस एग्ज़ाम. यू कैन फॉलो आवर चैनल फॉर मोर हेल्प एंड बेटर अपडेट्स. सो वी आर एयर ऑनलाइन टू हेल्प यू. अगर आप लोग को कोई भी डाउट्स हैं, कोई भी क्वेरीज हैं, कोई भी पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर आप लोग को समझना है तो आप लोग हम लोग को कमेंट बॉक्स में टाइप करके बता सकते हैं. सो वी विल क्लियर दोज चैप्टर्स. सो थैंक यू गाइज. आई एम क्लोजिंग ऑफ द सेशन. आई होप देर आर नो क्वेश्चन. सो आई एम क्लोजिंग ऑफ द सेशन.